some ways, we've got a country that is headed downhill as Rome was at its peak. And in other ways, we're as dominant and as impressive as Rome was at its peak.
If you watched the Republican National Convention last week and longed for the contentious conventions of old, you should be in Long Beach, California. The Reform Party is holding its national convention there, and the first thing it did was split in two. On one side, supporters of ultra-conservative Pat Buchanan. On the other, backers of party founder Ross Perot, who support little-known candidate John Hagelin. Steve Shigaris is an associate producer for CBS News and has been covering the Reform Party since November. Steve, sounds like a pretty interesting day.
Yeah, that's right. It wasn't just one convention. It wound up splitting into two conventions in adjoining, well, the halls were right next to each other. The original hall had the Buchanan folks nominating or planning to nominate Pat Buchanan as their candidate. And next door at the theater, they had the Hagelin folks over there planning to nominate Hagelin.
It seems like the party is self-destructing.
I don't know about self-destructing. What has happened is that they've split in half. And what is going to wind up happening is that both factions of the party are going to wind up submitting a request from the Federal Election Commission looking for $12.6 million, which one of the two parties is due. The FEC has to decide which of the two is valid. And that person, nominee, whether it's Hagelin or Buchanan, will get the 12.6, and then they could build from there. I mean, it's not necessarily dead.
What caused the split?
I think initially what had happened was the pro-Perot people had invited many candidates to try to join the Reform Party in search of a presidential candidate this year, Pat Buchanan being one of them, hoping that Buchanan would stay away from his right-wing social agenda and talk about the issues that he had in common, sort of the trade issues and immigration issues that he had in common with the Reform Party. And the pro-Perot people are complaining that he has strayed from that promise and has tried to inject his anti-abortion stance into the platform.
John Hagelin is an Ivy Leaguer, a physicist. Does he have enough experience to carry the party? What's the talk there?
Well, he's run twice before. He ran in 1992 and in 1996 under the Natural Law Party ticket, and he's also going to be their nominee again this year. What his goal is to merge the two parties and try to create this coalition third-party movement with the Reform Party and Natural Law Party. So he feels that if he can merge the two parties and talk to the people who don't vote normally, then maybe they can get some votes this year.
And where's Ross Perot in all of this? He's not even there.
Ross Perot's back in Dallas. And the last I heard is that he's extremely mad as to what has happened lately. There are rumors that I've heard from several people that he may make an appearance. I had heard that if there were two split conventions that he may fly in and speak to the pro-Perot convention. No word definitely if he's going to do that or not, but he's definitely watching.
Is there any talk of the issues or of platforms with all of this chaos?
Sure. The Reform Party stands for, they were based on anti-NAFTA stance back in when they started up in the early to mid-90s. There's plenty of talk about trade. There's plenty of talk about immigration. Hagelin gave his speech last night and talked about education issues and health care issues, which what he calls the disease care system. And Buchanan, the same thing. Buchanan is definitely, as a lot of people know, anti-immigration, and that's one of his big issues that he's talking about.
What do the delegates think of all of this?
Well, there's two sets of delegates as well. There's the people who have been with the party since the beginning, and a lot of them sounded disappointed. I think that they were hoping that Buchanan would be a big name to come into the party, and they'd be able to unify and grow the party with Buchanan. And what had happened was that they didn't agree with him, and they decided to split off. And the Buchanan people are ecstatic, because they got the pro-Perot people out. And those people are the ones that were against Buchanan to begin with.
What's on tap later today?
Later today, they're going to have the nominations. Each side will nominate their candidates. So there'll be two nominees. There'll be a Reform Party nominee, Pat Buchanan, and a Reform Party nominee, John Hagelin, that the Federal Election Commission will have to decide who's the real nominee.
So much for a dull convention. Steve Shigaris, associate producer for CBS News, thanks so much for joining us this morning.
Thanks.